The ideological changes that took place in the 19th century laid the foundations for the spiritual collapse in the next century. Whereas the majority of people believed in Allah's existence until that time, these changes enabled atheism to become a major influence. In the 18th century, such materialists as Denis Diderot and Baron d'Holbach asserted that the universe had existed forever, and that only matter existed, and this view found an ever-increasing following in Europe. In the 19th century, atheism expanded further with the influence of such thinkers as Feuerbach, Marx, Engels, Nietzsche, Durkheim, and Freud. Charles Darwin did the greatest service to atheism. On the basis of no scientific evidence whatsoever, by devising his theory of evolution, which was designed to oppose creation, Darwinism provided a scientific answer to the question of how humanity and other life forms emerged, a question that atheists had never managed to answer until that time. He proposed that nature had an imaginary mechanism that could by chance bring dead matter to life, and by chance give rise to millions of species. And many people believed this erroneous idea. At the end of the 19th century, atheists had formulated a worldview that, they claimed, explained everything. They postulated that the universe was not created, but had existed since eternity, and thus had no beginning. They assumed that its clear order and equilibrium was coincidental, and devoid of purpose. Darwinism claimed to answer the question of how humanity and all other beings were created. Marx and Durkheim provided atheistic answers to history and sociology, and Freud did the same for psychology. These theories, however, were shown to be baseless and without merit by the scientific, political, and social developments of the 20th century, and moreover, discoveries in astronomy, biology, psychology, and social behavior completely destroyed atheism's propositions. During this period, however, movements based on Darwinism and materialism devastated humanity. Such ideologies as communism, fascism, racism, nihilism, and existentialism caused people great sorrow and engendered countless conflicts, wars, and calamities. At present, the burden of responsibility rests upon the shoulders of all conscientious believers to do something about the global catastrophe created by all ideologies opposed to religious morality. All Christians, Jews, and Muslims should join in this effort, for they are the target of these atheistic ideologies. Therefore, the sincere people of the book and sincere Muslims must cooperate, join forces, and tell the world of Darwinism's false worldview, which is based on materialism, not science. All of the other anti-religious ideologies, e.g. communism, fascism, racism, as well as decadence, must be fought together on an ideological level so that the world can enjoy peace, tranquility, and justice in the near future. When this great task has been completed, suffering, hardships, killing, calamity, injustice, and destitution will make way for enlightenment, calmness, prosperity, wealth, health, and good fortune. As we have described throughout this documentary, Muslims and the people of the book possess exceedingly similar beliefs and perspectives on life. Members of all three faiths believe in the existence and oneness of Allah, that He created the universe and all living things, and that all people must order their lives according to the revelation coming from Allah. There is also very great similarities between the moral conception and ideal model of society described in the Quran and the uncorrupted parts of the Torah and the Gospel on those subjects. There is no doubt that alongside these similarities, there are also fundamental differences of belief. However, at a time of irreligious and atheistic ideologies, it is the resemblances between the three faiths that need to be emphasized, rather than the differences. Jews, Christians, and Muslims must put a complete end to historic problems between them. Prejudices, misconceptions, arguments based on bigotry, and other disputes. It is wrong and unfair to judge a person without knowing him, solely on the basis of the faith to which he belongs. Members of all three faiths must treat one another with understanding and affection, and not forget that there is not a day to lose over their common aims. The important thing is to concentrate on common features rather than differences, to make things easy rather than difficult, to be constructive rather than destructive, to bring people together rather than tear them apart. In conclusion, the duty of all believers is clear, whether they are Muslims, Jews, or Christians, to unite and join forces in order to establish societies dominated by peace, tranquility, prosperity, morality, goodness, happiness, and security. Every believing Christian, Muslim, and Jew is responsible to do whatever he or she can in this respect. If we coordinate our efforts for such a pure undertaking, Allah will give us success. It needs to be known that all of the walls that have been erected over the years among and against the followers of Islam, Christianity, and Judaism only help the unbelievers undermine and lead people further away from religious morality. No doubt, those who call to goodness recommend doing good and avoiding evil, and work together in this holy cause, can expect salvation and eternal happiness. The unbelievers will be at a loss, whereas the believers will receive an eternal reward.
I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed Satan.
By the late afternoon, truly man is in loss, except for those who believe and do right actions, and urge each other to the truth, and urge each other to steadfastness.